Hey, I'm ZSH Plays, and today I'm going to show you how to use billboards to make your zoo look awesome. What I'm going to show you how to do today is spread an image across multiple billboards so it fits perfectly using entirely free software. You don't need Photoshop, you don't need anything else. We can do it all for free. Let's get started. So we've got a lovely zoo entrance here, and some space is being left to put a sign in for the zoo's name across here. So we could use the in-game letters to do that, but there's only two fonts. They're not the most exciting. Maybe you want some graphics. Maybe you just want to make it a bit more you. So we're going to use billboards to put the sign in. There's loads of different sizes of billboards. The first thing we need to do is work out what size we're going to go with and how many we need. So if you try the biggest first of all, this is the 32 meter billboard. Make sure you don't use the lit version unless you want it to look like a TV screen. We use the unlit version. Place this in. And you can see straight away, it's not quite wide enough and it is way too tall. It is sticking out the top, it's obscuring the bottom. We don't want to be using this one. So let's go with the next size down. The next size down is 16 meters. So we'll move this one up here and straight away you can see the height is much better. It's not sticking out the top or the bottom. It's not obscuring the build. So if we get this in the right place, we'll be able to sit this in seamlessly like that. And then we'll slide it across to the left and start copying it. Place it down, make sure it's centered so the image is going to be in the right place, and then we'll just copy it across, line it up perfectly, do it again, and there we go, three billboards, and we filled that sign in perfectly. That is all we need to do in Planet Zoo for the moment. Now we're going to jump into some free software and get designing. To design the billboard, we're going to be using Canva.com, completely free image editing software available on desktop and mobile. But before we get designing, you need to know one thing about these billboards, the size that the image needs to be. I'll put a chapter point here so you can refer to it. The image size you need for these billboards is 1,824 pixels wide by 1,024 pixels tall. So to work out how big the image needs to be, all you need to do is multiply 1,824 by the number of billboards you're going to be using horizontally and 1,024 by the number of billboards you're going to be using vertically. In this example, our design is three billboards wide, so 1,824 times 3 is 5,472, and then we just need the default 1,024 high. Put that into create a design, and there we go. That is the image that we're going to be working with here, the perfect size for our billboard. Now, we don't want a plain white background, so let's go to Elements, and we'll choose a square, and I'm just going to fill the background in with a nice Planet Zoo style green. Obviously, you can do whatever you like with this. So we go to the color tool and pick that nice green down there, and then we'll put the zoo's name in. So we go to text, we'll add a title here, and then we're going to resize this so it exactly fills the image. It'll snap for you. We want to do that to make sure that the title is going to be in the center. And then we'll select the heading text and choose a nice font. There we go. We'll choose a nice generic name for the zoo, West Park Zoo. That's pretty generic. And make it a bit more interesting. We'll take the first two words and use the color tool to make them white. And then we'll take the word zoo and use the color tool to make that orange, give us a nice contrast, and then we'll size this up. Now you'll have to play around with the size a bit depending on the design of the entrance and how much space you've got. We'll move it back into the center. If you find you get that weird bug in Planet Zoo where when you import graphics they come up too light, then just use this color tool here to make each color a bit darker than you want it, and it'll show up fine in the game. Let's add one more thing to the sign, some graphics. So if we go back to Elements, we can search for anything we like. We'll go with an elephant, find some clip art, drop it in. Obviously you can draw these yourself, but if you're not artistic, just drop the elephant in. We'll copy that, move them over to the other side, and then use the snapping tools that show up automatically just to make sure everything is perfectly in line with each other, so we get something that looks nice and professional, or professional as that drawing of an elephant is ever going to look. And that is the sign done. So let's save this. We'll go to File and then Download. Make sure PNG is selected and then save this anywhere you like, doesn't matter where. And then we'll move on to the other piece of software that we're going to be using, ImageSplitter. So this is another piece of free software. All the links to these are in the description, so you can grab them yourself. Go to upload image and then select image, and we can put in the file that we just created. The little box in the middle tells you how this is going to be cropped, and we've got here columns and rows. The number of columns is how many billboards wide we want. The number of rows is how many billboards tall we want. So three columns, one row, and then just drag this selector so it fills the whole image. And you can see here we've got one, two, three images that are going to be output. So click the split image button and save this anywhere you like, and then download the zip file it creates. And here you can see the three images that we need. Now you need to extract these into the user media folder. Now this could be anywhere on your PC. It is wherever you installed Planet Zoo. Inside your Planet Zoo folder will be a user media folder, and we're going to extract the files there. If you can't find it, a simple search should do the trick. And now it's back to Planet Zoo. So select the first billboard. Find the correct image in the custom media folder, there we go. And then do the same thing with the second and third billboards. And now we have a beautiful sign. Probably would have been more beautiful if I'd spent more time on it, but this is a tutorial. I don't want to take up too much of your time. So we've got the sign in. It's not perfectly positioned, so we're going to select all three of the billboards, group them together, and then select the group. And that'll enable us to move it up and down and get it into the perfect place. So we'll get it roughly right from out here, and then we'll get a bit closer and get it perfect. And there we go. We have a beautiful sign for the front of the zoo. You can use this technique to do things like the mural at the bottom as well. Don't forget to hit the like button if you found this useful. If you like the zoo that you see here, you can see the building of this zoo on my channel. I'll put a link on the screen now. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you soon. Bye.